I have to block out thoughts of you so I don't lose my head.
Our Tennessee family is united in its goals, but divided in the right path to get there. I love Tennessee too much to let her stay divided. That is why I accept the university's decision.
I'm more than confident that our staff and players will be my last season around. Tennessee's head,
our history proves it.
Will you never call again? And will you never say that you loved me just to put it in my face? And will you never...
I'm still trying to figure out how he got the Oakland Raiders job, much less the Tennessee job. The guy was an assistant football coach at USC and became a head football coach in the National Football League. I don't think that's ever been done in history. I tell you one thing, though, I'm getting his agent. Because whoever his agent is doing a hell of a selling job.
Well, you know, there are already some skeptics and critics on Rocky Top. So they're saying that it was a, quote, cheap and easy hire. There was no buyout. Pay him a reported $2 million. There's a lot of people who don't think. Why not? You know, Mike Leach, Brian Kelly. There are other names out there who would be interested in that job. Why? You know, there are people wondering why.
We'll see.
Find out.
Maybe they have a commission. I'm really looking forward to embracing some of the great traditions at University of Tennessee. For instance, the ball walk, running through the tee, singing Rocky Top all night long after we beat Florida next year. It's going to be a blast. Okay, so get ready.
This is a recruiting violation. I'm going to turn Florida in right here in front of you. But as Matisse was here on our campus, his phone keeps ringing. And so one of our coaches is sitting in the meeting with him. He says, who's that? He looks at the phone and says, Urban Meyer. Okay? Just so you know, when a recruit's on another campus, you can't call a recruit on another campus. But I love the fact that Urban had a cheat.
As of June 6th, Tennessee itself reported 5 secondary NCAA recruiting violations that the football program has committed since Kiffin was hired. Those violations range from holding a simulated news conference for recruits to improperly using Twitter.
The 3 freshman players were charged with attempted armed robbery early Thursday morning. The trio of 18-year-olds includes wide receiver Nukeese Richardson, starting safety Jansen Jackson, and defensive back Mike Edwards. With one of them brandishing a handgun, they allegedly tried to rob 3 people who were sitting in a parked vehicle at a gas station on the edge of the school's campus.
I've talked to a number of folks over the last 24 hours, and he's been described as very intelligent, and I think you will see that very early in the conversation. Intense, disciplined, hard-nosed, a tenacious recruiter, a family guy, and extremely well-organized. Please help me welcome the 22nd head football coach at the University of Tennessee, Derek Dooley.
I'm humbled, I'm honored to stand before you as the next head football coach at the University of Tennessee.
Lost to Vols will have an opportunity.
The offensive team had more than 11 players. However, the ball was snapped and it hit the ground with 1 second.
Our staff offensively did a great job of putting together a plan in 3 days. Matt didn't see the plan until Tuesday, so we had Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday to try to perfect the plan, and they did a good job of carrying it out.
You were on against Tennessee as a player the last time they won. Now the snap, 26 in a row to snap it. What does that mean?
Oh, man, that means the world to me. Like I said, I didn't want to see any more of my highlights because that's what they show when you haven't beaten somebody in 26 years. Now it's time to start a new streak.